Okay, Kyra, here we go. A couple of ideas that we covered yesterday, and what we're looking at is the hi-hat here. And the thing that we started to do is, you know, being able to you know, lift that up and down while we play. So the one thing you can do is you'll see this right here on the side. I know mine's a little different with this part, but you still have this part on yours. And however far you step down, and you can see I'm stepping all the way down with the pedal there, and then tighten it by going clockwise, and then you lift it, and whoa, that might be too much, right? That's quite a gap there. So I'm going to lower it a little bit. I'm only going to step down maybe just a couple of inches. There we go, and that's enough usually. And then you'll notice underneath here that you'll have something like this. It might be more of a knob that comes down, and when you turn that, it will turn the hi-hat, the bottom of the hi-hat, like this or that, giving you more of a sizzle. You can see mine's automatically sizzling because I've kind of got it more closed on this side. So there was just a little demo of that. I'm going to put this in the camera holder here and demonstrate a little bit of the open hi-hat feel. Now, I know that it was tough to do that, wasn't it? It's always tough to try to open up the hat and also keep a beat going. So what I want you to try to do first is this. You're just going to try to hit it open. Remember, that's the H that's up in the air, right? And then when you close, you can do both H's at the same time by not only hitting it, but then also dropping the left foot down. So we do this, we go left foot up, left foot down, and then left foot up, and down. I'm just gonna kinda keep that going, just practice that. Just gotta kinda get used to it. And even if you just did that, you know, for the first couple days while you're trying to figure this out, then the next thing to do is to try to add a foot. So you're going to add your bass drum. So you're going to go lift and then your feet together as you hit the hat as well. Lift and then feet. There you go. Now we can also do that against the snare. So in this case, I go open. And then I do both hands, but then just my left foot, not my right foot. So I'll go. Like that. And then the big part, when you can put it all together at the end, is to do open bass. Open, snare, open with the bass, open with the snare. And the thing you have to realize is that you've already done this one beat, right? You've already done Boots and Cats, which is bass, hat, snare, hat, bass, hat, snare, hat, right? That's kind of what that is. Then you add the open hi-hat and a couple more hi-hat notes. So definitely takes a little while to get that. So be patient with, you know, putting all four of your limbs together like that. That's hard to do, both hands and both feet. So then the other beat that we looked at was doing one where we're going to start to get our hands to not do exactly the same thing all the time, right? So we end up with this kind of thing happening where we go right, left, right, left, right. Right, left, right, left, right. That's the main part of it. And then one more of those. So then what I'm going to throw together is just kind of one at a time. And where it happens is, you know, kind of in the middle of the beat. So you do this at first, regular beat, and then right here, right, left, right, together. And then back to the bass, hands together, right, right, hands together. A couple more. Right. Right, left, right, together, and one more. together, and very good. So then I think you get the idea with 13, 14, 15 in the Easy Beats and Breaks page that I gave you. And you know, the main beat that you're doing there is just delaying that bass drum by a little bit, right? So you're trying to go bass and snare, hat, hat, bass, snare, bass, snare, hat, hat, bass, snare. And that's kind of how I remember it, is after I hit the snare, I do two hi-hats before I do another bass snare right away, because you're kind of scooting it over a little. Here it is again. Bass snare, hat, bass snare, bass snare, hat, hat. All right, so there you go, the beat on that. And then I think you see what to do on the breaks. You know, that very first one was doing that snare, snare, bass, rest, one, one, three, three, you know, and then hitting a crash. Technically a crash, at least on this drum set, is the smaller ones. The bigger cymbals over here tend to be called ride cymbals. And the thing you'll do with those, right, you'll play like that, which is really the same thing that you were doing on the hi-hat. You're just moving it over to the cymbal. All right, good luck.